cuta wuta ta gani ta kukan ma.
Welcome back to our channel. It's your girl Fanilungu, back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. Like I said, my name is Fanilungu, and on this channel we post reaction videos each and every day. So if there's something that you guys want us to react to, let us know by dropping the link in the comment section below, and we'll be more than glad to do it. A big shout out to the person that suggested this. Today I'm going to be reacting to Prophet Muhammad's Love for Us. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
And then he said this following word, subhanAllah. وَدَدْتُ أَنْ لَوْ رَأَيْنَا إِخْوَانَنَا. I wish the only thing that I will miss is that I didn't get to see my brothers and sisters. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu was standing there listening to this, and he was confused along with the companions. He said, Ya Rasulullah, أَوَلَسْنَا نَحْنُ بِإِخْوَانِكَ. Are we not your brothers? We're here, we're standing next to you, Ya Rasulullah. What are you saying? Something gone wrong, Ya Rasulullah. And Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu was moved. He was scared. He said, Ya Rasulullah, are you okay? We are your brothers, we're here, we're here. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at him, and his face was tired, and he was slightly sad. He said, Ya Abu Hurairah, أنتم أصحابي. You are my companions. إخواني الذين آمنوا بي ولم يروني. My beloved brothers and sisters are the ones who believed in me but never had the chance to see me. لم يأتوا بعد. They have not come yet. I wish only that I could have seen them. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم indirectly is farewelling, but at the same time, the most important thing after meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is us. Did you realize that? Allah says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. There has come to you a prophet, a messenger of God, from among yourselves, like you, not better than you, from you. Any better, yes, as a messenger of Allah, but from you, the likes of you. When something, a hardship befalls you, it is so great upon his chest and heart. He cannot bear it. حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. He is so careful that you don't fall into harm. بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفُ الرَّحِيمُ. He is so kind and compassionate and merciful towards the believers. This is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, Ya Rasulullah, will you ever be able to see these brethren of yours anyway? Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ah, yes, as if I can see it. I will be waiting for them at the Hawd, at the fountain of Kawthar, on the day of judgment. And I will call them one by one to come and drink from my hand. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu was confused. He said, Ya Rasulullah, how will you know them when you have never seen them? And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, let me give you an example of a man who has many horses. Many of them are dark, pitch black in color. And among them there are horses with striped colors, white on their foreheads, white on their nose, on their backs, on their legs, on their tail. Is this person not able to tell the black horses from the ones that are striped very easily? He said, yes, Ya Rasulullah. He said, on the day of judgment it will be so. يَأْتُونَنِي غُرَّا مُحَجَّلِينَ. They will come to me on the day of judgment like this. When everyone else, because of their kufr and because of their bad deeds, their bodies and their faces will turn charcoal. These people will come and they have different colors on their bodies. This color is nur. Nur coming out from their faces, coming out from their arms, coming out from their legs. And Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu asked, where is this nur from, Ya Rasulullah? He said, وَذَٰلِكَ مِنْ أَثَرِ الْوُضُوءِ فَأَسْبِغُ الْوُضُوءَ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. This is the result of the wudu' which they used to make. So make your wudu extra good. Make your wudu extra good. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, ever since that day, every time I made wudu, I used to make isbagh. Isbagh means, instead of reaching just to the elbow, I'd just wipe a little bit more above. I'd enjoy it. Subhanallah, have you ever made wudu while you've enjoyed every drop that falls? Imagining every drop that falls has a sin on it that is dropping away. Enjoying your wudu like you enjoy ibadah, worship. And not just in performance for salat. Like Bilal radiallahu anhu, when Rasul sallallahu went to Isra al-Mi'raj, and he came back down and said, Ya Bilal, bima sabaqtana? What did you beat us in? Meaning, how come I heard you walking in front of me in Jannah, your footsteps? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I don't know. But at every salat I make wudu. And every time I lose it, I make it again. And he said, this is what the reason why I heard your footsteps ahead of me in Jannah. Ahead of him doesn't mean that he is better than the Prophet ﷺ, but he heard his footsteps literally in front of him, meaning in a distance away, he heard Bilal radiallahu anhu, and he wondered why Bilal radiallahu anhu has a future in Jannah in such a case. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then felt sicker. This was the month in which he died. And as he was walking down from the Baqiya back to his house, Rasul ﷺ felt a strong fever hit him like no fever he has ever felt before. It was on a Wednesday. And it was 5 days before he died, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Around him were some companions. And one of them was Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu anhu. He said, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I heard him say that Ibrahim alayhi salam said, Rabbi innahunna adlalna kathiran min al-nasi faman tabi'ani minhum fa innahu minni wa man asani fa innaka ghafurur rahim. Oh Allah, many of them of the people who were supposed to follow me, about Ibrahim alayhi salam, have lost and gone astray. So whoever follows me is from me. And whoever disobeys you, then you, Allah, are the most merciful, the forgiving. Then he recited the verse about Isa alayhi salam. إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكَ. Isa alayhi salam said, oh Allah, if you punish them, then they are your servants. وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْكَرِيمُ. And if you forgive them, then you are the most honorable and the generous. Then the Prophet ﷺ lifted his arms up after reciting these verses. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As said, then we heard the Prophet ﷺ say the following words, and as for I, Ya Rabb, as for me, meaning, if Ibrahim alayhi salam said this in his dua, if Isa alayhi salam said that in his dua, then as for me, Ya Rabb, Allahumma ummati, Allahumma ummati, Allahumma ummati. Oh my Lord, save my nation, save my nation, save my nation. Rasul sallallahu alayhi salam is farewelling. And the only thing on his mind is his ummah, us. The only thing on his mind are his companions and the generations to come whom he hasn't seen. He is leaving this world, and yet he is so caring for us as though he knows we are going to go astray, we're going to have hardships without him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so he made his famous dua, ثُمَّ بَكَى. He said he started to weep and cry until his beard was soaked with tears. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Jibreel, Ya Jibreel, go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and ask him what is making him cry, and his Lord knows why. So Jibreel alayhi salam said, Ya Rasulullah, your Lord asks you why you are crying and he knows why. Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa said, Ya Rabb, I want you to save my ummah. I fear for them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Jibreel alayhi salam, tell him Ya Jibreel, that I will make him pleased for his ummah, and I will not make him grieve over them. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahumma ja'alna min ummati Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said to him, I will make him pleased. سَأُرْضِيهِ وَلَا نَسُوءَهُ. We will not make him grieve. On the day of judgment, he will have al-wasila, the intercession which he has been promised. No other prophet will be given it except the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On the day when we will go from Adam to Nuh to Ibrahim to Musa to Isa until finally Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, every one of them will refuse. They will say, I have no power today. My Lord is so angry, he's never been angry like this before. Go to the one after me until we reach Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is the day when he will meet us again, insha'Allah, where he will raise his head and say, Ya Rabbi, Allahumma ummati, ummati. That day, when Allah will save his ummah. And he has never given something like this to any prophet before him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Love the message of this. I guess it's trying to show us how Muhammad loved his people. Do you know one thing that I've noticed this thing about prophets? What's the meaning when they say save my nation or save my people? What does it really mean? Because that can translate into two things, or love to believe. But otherwise, if there is someone out there praying for you, you best believe they love you. If there is someone out there wishing you to enjoy life, be safe and everything else, you best believe they really, really care about you and want you to have a good life and just, I guess, get blessings from God. Otherwise, this is what the entire video was about. For those of you that want to get into specifics, feel free to comment in the comment section below. We're more than glad to read your comments. If you have suggestions, drop the links in the comment section below and we'll be happy to react. A big shout out to the person that suggested this. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.